In this video, we will learn how the slice tool works. With this tool, you can create new 3D solids and surfaces by slicing or dividing existing objects. The cutting plane is defined with two or three points by specifying a major plane of the UCS or by selecting a planar or surface object. One or both sides of the sliced objects can be retained. You can find the slice tool in the solid editing panel of the home ribbon, or you can simply type slice in the command line and press enter to activate it. Once the tool is active, I have to select the objects I want to slice. So I will select the objects and press enter. Then the message "Specify start point of slicing plane" appears. This means that I need to define the first point of the cutting plane. The default option defines the cutting plane using three points. I have created a line to make it easier for you to see exactly where I click. Once I click on the first endpoint of the line, another message prompts me to specify the second point of the cutting plane. I will click on the second point of the line, and the cutting plane will be specified. Now I have to define which side of the object I want to keep. I can either click on the side I want to keep or press enter to keep both sides. In this example, I will click on the right side of the object. Notice that the left side has disappeared. If I selected both sides, the object would be cut according to the plane I specified, but both sides would remain. However, each part would be a different object. Apart from specifying the cutting plane using three points, AutoCAD provides us with several different methods to define the cutting plane. To see how those options work, I will activate the slice tool again. Next, I will select the objects I want to cut and press enter. At this point, the options about the cutting plane appear in the command line. This time, I will select the planar object option. Once I select this option, AutoCAD displays the message "Select a circle, ellipse, arc, 2D spline or 2D polyline." So I will select the object that specifies the cutting plane, and then I will click on the right side of the object to discard the left side. If I wanted to keep both sides, I could just press enter. The next option is the surface option, which, as its name indicates, aligns the cutting plane with a selected surface. Once I select this option, a message prompts me to select a surface. When I select it, I have to define which side of the object will be kept. Since I want to keep the right side of the object, I will click on the right side, and again, the left side will be discarded automatically. Next is the Z-axis option. This option specifies the cutting plane by specifying a point on the plane and another point on the Z-axis of the plane. With this option, I need to click on a point on the cutting plane first. Then, I have to specify a point on the Z-axis of the plane. This point must be perpendicular to the cutting plane. Lastly, I have to specify a point on the desired side. This time, I will click on the bottom side of the object and notice that the upper side has disappeared. At this point, I will show you how the View option works. This option aligns the cutting plane so it is parallel to the current viewport's viewing plane. You also have to specify a point to define the location of the cutting plane. Once you select this option, AutoCAD displays the message "Specify a point on the current view plane." I will click to define a point on the view plane, and then I will click again to define which side I want to keep. Again, I will click on the right side of the object. Notice the final result. The three last options, XY, YZ, and XZ, align the cutting plane with the XY, YZ, and XZ planes of the current UCS respectively. Starting with the XY option, as I mentioned before, it aligns the cutting plane with the XY plane of the current UCS, and all I have to do is specify a point to define the location of the cutting plane. So I will select this option, and then I will click to specify the location of the cutting plane. Finally, I will click on the bottom side of the object to discard its upper side. The slice is finished. After the XY option comes the YZ option, which aligns the cutting plane with the YZ plane of the current UCS, and again, I have to click to define the exact location of the cutting plane. So I will select this option, and then I will click to specify the location of the cutting plane. Finally, I will click on the right side of the object to discard its left side and notice the result. Last but not least is the XZ option, which aligns the cutting plane with the XZ plane of the current UCS, and like the two previous options, I have to click to define the location of the cutting plane. This time, I will select this option and then I will click to specify the location of the cutting plane. Finally, I will click on the left side of the object to discard its right side and notice the result.